Hi everyone, it's Sam from SiteMate. In this video, we're going to take a look at the Dashpivot mobile app and cover the basics. I should start by saying that the Dashpivot app is available on both iOS and on Android and works on phones and on tablets. So feel free to download the app if you haven't already and try it out for yourself. You can download the app off the Apple App Store or the Google Playstore. And when using the app, it doesn't really matter whether you're using it on a phone or on a tablet, but some of the more complex types of templates, such as method statements and inspection test plans, can look a lot nicer on the larger screens when there's typically a lot more information to be displayed. But that said, you can still get by using the phone app. It just requires a little bit more scrolling side to side to see all of the table content. So when you first log into the app, it will load the first project team that you have access to, and the name will be displayed up the top. On the top left-hand side, we have our navigation icon. If we tap on this, we can actually see all of the projects and teams that we have access to. You can also search in this section up the top here, if you're looking for something specific. If you need to change teams, this is where you can do it. You just tap on the team that you want to go to. In the top right, we have our profile. So it'll have your initials displayed there. If we open it up, there'll be a couple of options. The first option is to access all of our help articles in our Help Center. We have an option to chat with our team directly via live chat. And then we have a couple of settings relating to the photos section. The first is photo stamp preferences, where you can choose what information is stamped onto your photos. And the second is to save photos to your device. So if you take a photo or video, it will save a local copy to your phone. In the center of the screen, you can see that we have some photos here. And that's because we're in the photos section of this project team. We also have a section called templates, which we'll take a look at in just a moment. But in the photos section and in the template section, it's worth noting that the contents here, so these photos or the forms that we'll see in the template section, will be unique to this particular team. So if we opened up our navigation again and switched to a different project or a different project team, the photos that we would see and the forms within those other teams would be different to what we see here. So the photos here are only relating to this project team. So the photos, everything's organized by date. So you can see we've got the most recent ones up the top, and you'll notice the dates are going back in time as we scroll down. You can continue scrolling until you get back to the very first photo that was uploaded on this project. And so it makes it really easy to find any records that you might be looking for. If you want to look at a photo, you can just tap on it and it will show you the photo and some additional information about it, like who took it, the time and date, descriptions, things like that. You can also take a photo using the app by clicking this camera icon here. As an example, just going to take a photo of this window. We have the option to mark it up. We can click done once we're happy with that. We can click the next button to continue, but I just want to show you that you can also upload photos from your gallery so that are stored locally on your device. Those photos that you upload will be put under the date that those photos were taken, not under the date that they were uploaded. So if you took some photos from last week and upload them today, they're going to show up under last week's date, not today's date. And so if we just continue, we can actually upload a batch of photos at a time. In this video, we're just going to do one, but you could do up to 100. And you see we've got a photo review screen. So this is where we can add a description for the photo. We can select some tags. I'm just going to do one really quick. And once we're happy with what we've added in here, we can click save. And it will start to upload that information directly into Dashpivot. We get a message telling us that it's uploading. And then we get this little spinner on the photo and a little check mark once it has been uploaded. So it's very easy to take photos inside of Dashpivot, and as soon as the information is uploaded, anyone who's got access to this team will be able to access that photo and all the other photos that are in here. So someone who's also on site on their phone or on their tablet, or someone back at an office, you know, on their computer, will now be able to access and view and comment on the photos that have just been uploaded. So it's really quick. Now we're going to move across to the template section. And you can see here that we have quite a number of templates. They're organized into different categories. So you can see that we've got commercial, then we've got safety. If we continue scrolling down, we've got environmental. All of these templates here are organized via the website. So templates are created, edited, and managed via the website, but you can fill them out using the app. And so everything's nice and organized. We've got some different tabs along the top here, so it makes it really easy to find anything specific that we might be looking for. And we've got a search bar up the top, so you can find specific templates very quickly. There are actually two types of templates, and we'll take a look at both in this video. We have a timeline style template, like this site diary here that has these horizontal bars. And we also have workflows, which are these intertwining arrows. We'll take a look at both, but if we take a look at the timeline first, we'll take a look at this site diary. Similar to photos, all of the forms have been organized by date. So you can see we've got the most recent ones up the top. And as we scroll down, we're actually going back in time. You'll notice that the dates are going further and further back in time. If we wanted to view any of these records, we can just tap on it and it will open up the form that was filled out. If we want to create a new one, we just tap on this green plus button and it pulls up a fresh new form for us to then fill out. And I won't go through everything in this video, but we've got, you know, date fields, category fields, we've got text inputs, we can add photos, we can fill out tables, things like this, and we can also sign off. So that's the timeline style template. I'll now show you the workflow. It's very similar. We're going to take a look at this variation tracking workflow. It's laid out slightly different to the timeline. We don't have all of these date breaks and sort of ordering all the forms vertically. Instead, we have a series of columns where the forms are organized into each of those columns. So you can see this particular workflow has four columns, starting with foreman, then it goes to project manager, then it goes to contract admin, and then it goes to approved. So all of the forms have somewhat of a status associated with them, depending on what column they're sitting in. And the way to move the forms between the columns is to sign them off. If we want to create a new form, it's the same process. We just click the green plus button, pull up a new form, fill it out. And then once we sign it, it'll move to the next column. And then if we sign it again, it'll move to the column after that, and so on and so forth. The goal is to move the forms from the first column to the last column. And similarly to photos, as soon as you fill out a form or make a change to a form and save it, it will upload that directly into Dashpivot for the rest of the team to access. Whether they're on a phone, a tablet, or back at the office on a computer, they'll be able to access the information straight away. And the reverse also applies. So if someone else uploads a photo or fills out a form and uploads that into Dashpivot, the app is constantly checking for updates in the background. So if there's any new information related to this team, for any of these templates or any new photos, those will be made available to you straight away. The last couple of things to note is that the app does work offline. So if you don't have an internet connection, because you're in a rural area or a basement or somewhere that just doesn't have service, you can continue to use the Dashpivot app. You can fill out forms, you can upload photos, and then when you regain a connection, it will upload all of that content. And the app does have autosave and draft mode built into it as well. So if you are filling out a form and your battery died, or you accidentally shut down the app, or you needed to take a phone call, a draft of the form that you're filling out will be saved into Dashpivot, so that the next time that you open the app, it'll be sitting there ready for you. It'll just be marked as a draft. You can open it up, continue, and pick up where you left off, and then just press save once you're done, and it will upload directly into Dashpivot. So that concludes this video. If you get stuck with anything, you can reach out to our team either via the live chat on our website or via the mobile app. And thanks for watching.